students, welcome back to our 11 commerce economics class. Today I will show how to draw the pie diagram, okay, or pie chart. So first, what do you mean by the pie diagram or pie chart? So pie diagram means pie diagram means this diagram we present by circle and by parting this circle, that means we make various segment of this circle, and these various segments show the different values of the data. Okay, so let's see what is the pie diagram. Pie diagram is a circle which divided into various segments showing the percent values of a series. This diagram does not show absolute value. Okay, so pie diagram means the diagram which we define by or we represented by a circle, and this circle divide into various segment, and each segment shows the its values of data. So clear students, what do you mean by the pie diagram? Now let's see how we will draw the pie diagram. So for constructing pie diagram, can I rub this one? Completed this one? Type message. Yes or no? Pie diagram is a circle divided into various segments showing the percentage values of a series. This diagram does not show absolute value. So this pie diagram we represented by a circle, now for drawing the pie diagram you need the compass and protractor. Okay, now I have no compass, so that's why it will not be a perfect circle. So, see, if this circle we divide into four equal segments, then each segment create 90 degree angle, right? So see this angle also 90 degree, this angle also show 90 degree, this also show 90 degree. So this four are 360 degree angle. Okay. Now some data are given. So first, which values are given in data, we convert into percentage. This percentage we converted into degree, and after that we show this value in the diagram. So here brands offsets given, and here units sold in one place, Panipat. So first brand Samsung, which 480. Next Akai 360, Onida 240, and Sony 120. Now we convert this into percentage. So here write down sale in percentage. So first find out the total 0, 10, 10, 20, 0, carry 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1200. Then find out the percentage, actual value divided by the total value into 100, and we get how much? 40%. Same this one, 30, 20, and 10%. Now we convert this percentage into degree instead of 360 degree. So sales in terms of components of 360 degree. Simple, this percentage we multiply with 360 degree, and we get here 144 degree. Next 30% into 360 degree. Like this. So you also can easily find out this one. Okay, Devargo, write down. This sale in percentage, I hope all of you understood. This only first here I showed, others you find out yourself. 360 divided by 1200 into 100 is equal to 30. 240 divided by 100 into 20 into 100 is equal to 20. 120 divided by 1200 into 100 is equal to 10. Can I rub, students? I hope these first two columns are completed. Next, draw circle. You must use protractor, okay? This is the center of the circle. Okay, so our first component of cell of 144 degree. So first, from the center, you draw one line like this. Then here, put the protector. First one is how much? 144 degree. Next, join this. This one is Samsung, cell of Samsung. Next, 108. Okay, if you want to take the 7236, you also can take. This one is not necessary that you draw the one by one. Okay, if you first want to draw 36 degree, then also it will correct. Okay, if you draw from first 72 degree, then also it is correct. Next, I draw here 36. Again, put here the protector. Next, 30, 36 is here. Automatically in the rest of the path we will get the 108 degree. Okay, next here put 72. This one is Onida, and this one, obviously you measured this one. See, this is absolutely 108 degree, and this one is Akai. Okay, student, listen, for the various segment you also can use the various color. Okay, so by this we can draw the pie diagram. Devargo, completed? very good. And another student, what is your name? Have you understood or not? Kritika, okay, very good. Okay, so now I will give one question as homework. You will try this one your home. Can I rub? Write down the taste of people of a society for different type of food. Recorded as follows. Okay, so the taste of 500 people of a society for different type of food was recorded as follows. Now, types of food. In the below number of people, first type of food, North Indian, number of people 150, South Indian 100, Chinese 125, Italian 75, Mexican 50. Question is, draw a pie diagram to represent the above data. Okay. Okay, completed student. Next today, we discuss the frequency diagram. Under the frequency diagram, we already learned this one. There are the histogram, polygon, and ojai. Okay, histogram, frequency, polygon, and ojai. So, what is the frequency diagram? Frequency diagram means, you already know the frequency distribution. Frequency means the number, whatever number is given, this number how many times occurs. That means in one class, 14 students got 20 marks. So, for 14 students, their frequency is 20. For the 20 marks, their frequency is 14. So, the number, particular number or what is the data is given, this data, how many times occurred, this is called the frequency. And also in the data series, you already seen the frequency distribution also given. So, this or such type of the frequency distribution, when we represent by a diagram, this is called the frequency diagram. And first, today we learn from this histogram. Okay, Kritika, frequency means, say, if in class 11 commerce, some students in economics, okay, first we write down here, marks in economics and number of students. Okay, this is called the frequency distribution. Now, marks, some students out of 50 get 15, 20, 30, 40, like this. So, 10 students get 15 marks out of 50. 5 students get 20 marks. 15, 30, and again another 10 got 40 marks. So this number, this 15 marks, how many times occurs? 10 times. This is called the frequency distribution. Clear, Kritika? Okay, very good. So, this frequency distribution we represent by the frequency diagram. So, today we talk about the histogram. So, what do you mean by the histogram? Histogram same as the bar diagram, but here some specifications are given. A histogram is a graphical representation of a frequency distribution. So, whatever is frequency given, this frequency we draw by the diagram, this is called the histogram. And of a continuous series. Continuous series means what? Continuous series means sum 0 to 10. 10 to 15. See here, no breaking. Okay. This is called the continuous series. 10 to 15 to 20, this is called the continuous series. Or discrete series means like 10 to 5, 6 to 11, like this. Okay, so this continuous series or frequency distribution, when we will show by the diagram, this is called the histogram. So, write down a histogram. This will be clear by the example. First, see this one. A histogram is a graphical presentation of frequency distribution. of a continuous series. Okay, write down this one. Next day I will show how this histogram draw or represent by a diagram. First today only write down this definition. A histogram is a graphical presentation of frequency distribution of a continuous series. Having any problem for today's topic? Devargo, Kritika, yes, Kritika, tell me what is your problem. Have any problem now? So next day I will continue this class. So today I will stop here. Yes, Devargo. Okay, very good, both of you. Okay, so for today, thank you.